I literally felt like I was drowning, like gasping for air, like screaming underwater and nobody could hear me. I was dying.
I want all my children to know the Lord.
She doesn't even know how much of a necessity she has been to my life. She doesn't even understand where I would be if I didn't have her strength to keep me going.
We're so close that we almost know what we're thinking. We're so close that she knows what I like. We're so close that I know what she likes. And we discuss everything that we can, and we know everything about each other and our secrets and everything.
I look at her and my brother as my tripod, three legs. And if you take one away, you can't hold the camera up. They are my tripod and my success, I guess, with the camera.
Victory and refusing to lose, because failure was never an option. So I continue to prevail. I know some people would love to see me derail, but I stay on the road to success, and I won't accept anything less. So if you see me as a threat, I understand.
To that end, we always want to hear from today's generation. My friend Jay, whose poem brought us to this place, is with me along with some of her friends. Jay, what are your thoughts?
Well, for me, I feel like as an artist, we almost have like superpowers, like that we have the ability to kind of step outside of ourselves, if only just for that moment.
Wanting to be a filmmaker is beyond my understanding, but she's got good goals, and I'm just praying that the Lord will help on her goals and her dreams.
Worry about stuff too.
I know.
You got grown kids and grandkids. So.
I try to tell her that all the time. Like, let us do something. She's like, no.
Don't poison yourselves. But I'm learning little by little. I'm learning to let them do it.
Yeah.
You got to realize that God makes things happen in order. When you trust in Him.
Yeah, but I feel
it's an order that the elderly die first and the young. That's an order. That's an order. God's orderly.
The hardest thing that I'll ever go through. Like, there's nothing to compare it to. Like, that shit hurts my heart every day, every time I think about it. I felt like I was drowning. And when I left home, like, I started to feel like, you know, I'm starting to tread water just a little bit, you know, like, I'm watching my dreams manifest. I'm seeing what I want, then I'm getting it. Like, every sign in the universe, every sign that God could ever give me, he gave me. Like, so coming here, taking that leap of faith, leaving everything, I had to stop teaching myself how to drown. I had to stop dwelling on all the negative stuff and, you know, realizing that I am alive. I did survive. Like, I could have been in them streets. I could have been hustling. I could have been doing all kind of crazy stuff. I took those experiences that the people around me were going through, and I made it my own. I made it my baggage. I carried it around with me everywhere I went. I carried everybody's stuff, and I wanted it. I wish I could have took it for them, because I felt like I was strong enough to do it. But over time, I was drowning.
I can't.
You're almost done.
I can't.
You're almost done.
there's so many of them. Oh my God. We're running.